country if I go.
Hi guys, in this video I'm going to be showing you how to paint colorful smoke, just like in this picture I have done here. Alright, first of all, you'll need your pitcher that you're going to be putting the smoke in. This is my pitcher, and I have pre-painted the rest of it beforehand, and I will be this white space that I have left between the stripes is going to be my smoke. The next step is you're going to want to choose your colors. My smoke is going to be purple. You're going to want two shades. I have used here violet watercolor and dioxin purple acrylic. I am using two different types of paints, acrylic and watercolor, just to kind of blend the effects. Watercolor does give it more of a smoky kind of texture, but also I use acrylic to make sure that I do get the color that I want. So I have diluted down the color with white to make it more of a lavendery color. And again, you're going to want two different shades. So I have this lighter color, which is going to be my main color. And it's also the acrylic paint. And then this color here, which is a slightly darker purple. And it is my my watercolor. I won't be using as much as the darker color, but it does add definition. And it does give it that smoky color because smoke has a lot of different kind of colors and textures in it. Alright, another thing is if you are diluting your color down, you always want to put your white first and then add just a little bit of your actual color. Because if you start with the darker color first, you're just going to get a lot more paint than you originally intended. So always start with your lighter color when you mix colors. Alright, now let's get started. Alright, when adding your base coat, all you're gonna do is basically just color in all of your smoke space with your lighter color. It's alright to leave a little bit of space kind of around the edges or in between. You don't have to completely fill it in or make it all even all over. It's okay if you have some sections that are lighter than the others, because then this just gives it kind of that wispy effect that we're looking for. Alright, and on step two, you're going to want to make sure you use a lot of water so that way your darker lines don't stand out too much against your base coat. You want to make sure that they're nice and wispy looking. And if you do have some lines that overlap each other, you're going to want to make sure that the edges are dark against the second strand so that way they don't look like they're connecting with each other. This is important, and you can see me doing this with my strands. Good luck!